council chambers located at 1720 West Main Street, Gun Barrel City, Texas 75156, on Wednesday, July 13th, 2016 at 5 p.m. Roll call from my left.
Osborne here.
Slinglin here.
Schiff here.
Butler here.
Whitten here.
Great. We have a quorum, and I'd like to ask you to please stand for the invocation. As we gather here today as members of the Economic Development Corporation, we pray that we are ever mindful of the opportunities to render our service to our fellow citizens and to our community. We are thankful for this day that you have given us, for its blessings, for its opportunities, and of course, its challenges. We are also thankful for our city leaders, our police and fire departments, our men and women in the armed services who strive every day to keep us safe and sound, including those in the recent tragedies in Dallas. May we continue to appreciate and use each day as it comes to us. We pray for strength and guidance for each day's duties, for each day's problems, and ask the strength to give our best always with the reassurance that your presence is with us. Amen. Can I have two young gentlemen that are here? They're going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Come on up, guys. Face the flag and you start us off.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Good job. Okay, before we begin, we have just a quick video that that Holland was able to put together for us that we'd like to share with you with some of the events from the skate park opening from last Friday.
Sorry, we didn't get the audio on the speakers there.
Thank you.
Thank you, Holland. Really well done. Thank you.
I'd like to give my wife a shout out. She actually put that together.
So. Yeah, good job. Thank you. Thanks for sharing all that. Megan, welcome.
Thank you.
We have, we'll move on the agenda right now. So first item is citizen presentations limited to 3 minutes. This item provides the opportunity for citizens to address the EDC Board of Directors on any matter, whether or not it's posted on the agenda. However, in accordance with the Texas Open Meetings Act, Section 551.041, the EDC Board of Directors cannot discuss, deliberate, or take action on matters not listed on the agenda. At this time, the Board will receive citizen comments that, if necessary, may refer the matter to EDC staff for research, resolution, or referral to the EDC Board on a future agenda. I have only one person that has completed the form to, for request to speak tonight, and that's Mr. Ray.
Thank you to the EDC board for allowing me to address you this evening. After the events that have occurred this past week, I take great satisfaction in being able to address a positive occurrence. That is the direction that this board has taken in the last year or so. I cannot express how proud that I am in this board under the direction of Stephen Schiff. When I was on this board with David Skaines and many of the current members, we made a decisive decision to follow a path towards the marketing of this city and the quality of life for our citizens. This path has been followed by the current board with a focused vision and hard work. One of the culminations of this hard work is our skate park. The grand opening was something of which our city can be extremely proud. That grand opening was probably one of the best events this city has seen in quite some time. I'd like to thank Stephen Schiff and every member of this board for making that possible. Our mayor and his wife brought the idea of a skate park to our EDC and city council. It was worked on and brought to fruition by many people. But with perseverance and hard work on the part of our EDC, city council, and city staff, our young people have a place for an activity they truly enjoy. Once again, I want to praise this board for a truly spectacular grand opening. With impressive attendance, motivational presentations, and enjoyment throughout, our city was justifiably proud. The EDC is currently working on many, many projects, which will bring new business to our city and events that will bring enjoyment to all. My only plea is that you, the board of the EDC, stay the course. There will always be obstacles, but one thing that I have learned in my short tenure on the city council is that if a project is worthwhile, it is always worth fighting for. You are all a fantastic asset to our city, and I would be proud to support all of you for the betterment of our city. And lastly, I'd like to just for 1 second, encourage everybody in this city, if you have the opportunity to thank one of our police officers while they're working, just a handshake and a thank you, I think means more to them than anything else, and I would encourage that.
Thank you, Rob. All right, let's move on with the agenda. Item number one, discuss or take action to approve the EDC meeting minutes of June 15th, 2016.
I'll make a motion we approve the EDC minutes from June 15th.
Second.
Any discussion? Voting from my left?
Osborne, yes.
Slingerland, yes.
Lindemann, yes.
Yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Motion passes. Item number two, discuss or take action to approve the May 2016 Gun Barrel City EDC month-end financial reports. Holland, anything?
No, we're underrunning our budget for the year. We have, you know, less than a quarter of the year left to go, and we're following our budget.
Can I have a motion to approve the month-end financial reports?
I make a motion to approve the May 2016 Gun Barrel City EDC month-end financial reports from Holland Witten.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Schlingman, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Witten, yes.
Motion passes. Item number three, discuss or take action to accept a report on the Texas Open Meetings Act relating to items that can be discussed in executive session and the recording on minutes for regular and special EDC board meetings. Give me a second here. I've done a little bit of research because there were some questions that were posed about what basically can be discussed in executive session. I went through the handbook of the Open Meetings Act from 2014, and there are basically 19 different things that can be discussed in executive session. I could read each one of them to you if you want, or we can just take a look at the page that's included in your packet. But there are things that are outside of just discussing real estate property and personnel that are included in this document that is included in your packet. The second thing that's in that in your packet is that there are also in discovery, there are also special verbiage in the EDC hand in the not the EDC but the Open Meetings Act handbook where minutes for the meeting necessarily do not have to be written and published. Holland, do you want to chime in here?
Sure. There is a provision in the Open Meetings Handbook for using the video recording that we have for these meetings. So what I'd like to propose is that we have an index into that recording where that says how many minutes into the meeting each item was discussed, so that it's very easy to research items from the video. And I put a pencil to the savings. I think if we didn't do this, it would avoid a cost of about $1,500 a year transcribing these meetings. It's a very time-consuming process, and it would free up our support to do other tasks that need to be done.
And although we strive to do these on a very, very consistent basis, when we have things that crop up, like an illness or an injury, that prevent us from doing it, to Holland's point, it's a very time-staking task in order to sit there and to record the minutes verbatim. So basically, if you go into the handbook and look in the handbook, the recording or the video recording can act as the official minutes for the meeting, and to Holland's point, we could save some time, energy, and finances. Is there anybody on the board that would like me to read the 19 things that are allowed to be discussed?
No.
I've read them.
Because I'm more than happy to do that. So anyway, so Holland, did you want to make a motion?
I move we dispense with written minutes and instead provide an index into the video or audio recording, depending on where the meeting was held, that covers each item on the agenda.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left?
Osborne, yes.
Schlingman, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Witten, yes.
Motion passes. Item number four. Discuss or take action to accept Gary Damiano's resignation as an officer of the EDC board as vice president. Do I have a motion to accept Gary's resignation as the vice president of the board?
I move that we accept Gary Damiano's resignation as an officer of the EDC board as vice president.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Well, I'd like to go on record, if I could, just thanking Gary for the work he's done as vice president. We all appreciate what you've done, Gary.
Thank you very much.
And I'll second that.
Absolutely. Thank you, Gary.
Thank you all.
Any further discussion?
Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Slingman, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Butler, yes.
Witten, yes.
Motion passes. Item number 5, discuss and or take action to elect a new vice president of the Gun Barrel City Economic Development Corporation. Do I have any nominations?
Nominate Michael Slingerland for vice president.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left.
Yes.
Yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Or yes.
Witten, yes.
Congratulations, Michael.
Here.
Item number 6. Discuss and or take action to receive a report from the Texas Rural Challenge that was recently attended by Holland Witten and Gary Damiano. Holland, do you want to start?
I want to point out just a few of the specific things I brought back that were valuable to me on the EDC. One is a contact with the U.S. Census from Fort Worth. It was very helpful getting demographic data to update our website. Another is an outfit called GrantWorks that was one of the exhibitors there who are going to come in and talk to us about potentially working with us for grants this year or next year for the city. Another is the idea that we'll be talking about a little later about a business interest group, which was came out of one of the breakout sessions. Finally, the city itself was worth going to see. It's been a while since I've been to Waco, and you talk about a city that's found its legs and kind of found its stride. It's a great, dynamic city. Everybody is very excited about it. The conference center was a beautiful location. The other locales they took us to were just first rate. So I came away with a great impression of Waco, you know, the role model we'd like to be when we grow up there.
Gary, you want to add?
Yeah, let me concur with because I had some of the same meetings and discussions that Holland had, so with his report. I also had a chance to talk to Larry McManus, who is with Texas Economic Development Corporation. He has offered to – there's something out there called asset-based marketing, which has to do with a city taking a hard look at itself, figuring out what it is and what it's selling when it comes to being an EDC or being a city. And Larry's offered to send somebody down and do an inventory for us on what our assets or what our inventory is the things that we're marketing, such as the lake, such as the skate park, and a few other things. One of the other things, I had a chat with an organization. One of the things that they do that I found very interesting is that they are willing to send, this kind of dovetails with something that's on our agenda anyways. They will send somebody out to do a, for lack of a better term, I'm going to say a women's business entrepreneurial startup class to help women start businesses. I think it'd be valuable out here and give people a leg up on some of this stuff. I also learned that some of the small towns, this is a rural business economic development conference. It's focused at small cities like Gun Barrel, some smaller. And I'm learning that a lot of them have some of the same problems that we do. They have low voter turnout. They have limited funds in many cases. And that having a chance to talk to these folks and figure out and listen to how they're handling certain problems has been great. It's a good experience. It is a conference that I would suggest that the board consider going to every year. It's one, it's more applicable than some of the other things that we might entertain going to. Okay, that about sums it up.
Good. So just so everybody's clear, it was a 2-day conference that was held in Waco.
Yes.
This year. So, yeah. And Gary and Holland had volunteered to go. So appreciate you both attending. Some of the takeaways are good. I know we have some things already in action, so it's real good. Can I get a motion to accept this report?
I move we accept the report that we just heard from Holland and Gary.
Second. And then a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Flynn, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Danner, yes.
Butler, yes.
Witten, yes.
Discuss or take action to create a quarterly meeting at a location that will change per meeting to promote entrepreneurship, financial skills, and related business skills for the residents of Gun Barrel City. AKA, this will be called BIG, the Business Interest Group. Holland, this came out of that, correct?
Right. Breakout sessions that they were doing this to foster entrepreneurship. And just today I came across a quote that said, entrepreneurship is the most sure way of economic development. So this is right in our wheelhouse. And something that I think can help the city grow from the grassroots and help the citizens of the city. The idea is to hold quarterly meetings to promote entrepreneurial thinking, encourage experimentation, have loosely structured public meetings at a public venue, and connect young people, old people, investors, innovators, and people who are just looking for a better work situation around the city. So I'm committed to making this happen, and I would ask the other board members to help on occasion to use your expertise in these meetings.
So I was going to suggest, so there's actually, like, if you really break this down, there's 7A, 7 and 7A that's part of this. I think the first chore is to agree to create the quarterly meeting as described in the item number. And then I think part A of that would be to figure out whether there's a committee that's involved to do this or whether you'll take it over from the beginning and then, you know, decide who else could be part of that or however else you want board members to be involved. So I think there's two parts to this. So if someone's going to make a motion, I think it's got a two-part motion to it.
Are you looking for two motions or one?
I think I'm looking for two. Yeah.
I know what I was thinking.
Like 7 and 7A.
Okay. I'd like to make a motion is that we create, we have asked Colin Witten to spearhead and create a quarterly meeting agenda at a location to be arranged regarding entrepreneurship, financial skills, and related business planning skills for Gun Barrel City.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
I just have one question.
Yep, go ahead.
Just throwing it out there, is monthly too much? Is quarterly not enough? Can we massage this as we need to?
I had started with the idea of having it more frequently, but I think quarterly is a good place to start.
Okay.
That we kind of ease into this. We can take what we learned from the first meeting, adapt for the next one.
I would tend to agree, too.
Sounds good.
So.
Holland, I have a question.
Sure.
Did they provide you with a material or some sort of format for this, or is this just something that you're going to create as we go?
No, it would be created as we go.
Okay.
There's a lot of information out there.
Just so that we can all help you with material and stuff. Okay.
So maybe what we should do at some point is to have a special session or a special meeting and talk about what should be incorporated. Or from your perspective, what should be incorporated and have us all agree on it? I don't know. I'm asking.
I think a committee, if we had a committee, that'd be great. If those who are interested would let me know, then I'll pass the names on to Steve, and maybe you could just appoint
an
EDC committee of interested people.
All right.
Okay. So I move we establish a committee to do the initial planning for the business interest group.
We had a motion and a second.
Second.
And so any other discussion? Voting from my left, then.
Born, yes.
Slingerland, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Witten, yes.
Great. Thank you, Holland. I think it's a great idea.
Yes. Yeah,
thank you.
It actually leads itself into the next one, item number 8. Discuss or take action to determine a date, time, and location for the EDC-sponsored local business roundtable event. So We have in our budget this year monies that are allocated for a local business roundtable event. This was a roundtable event was held, somebody help me, was it last year, Jim? The year before?
Year, 2 years ago.
2 years ago. I think we skipped last year, right?
We did.
Or it didn't happen last year. So we'd like to start doing this again. We found it to be, from the notes that I read, they found it to be very, very successful, and it got businesses a chance to get together and to discuss issues and partner with each other in an event that the EDC is basically sponsoring. So I think we need to figure out a time and a date and a location. Go ahead, Mandy.
No, I agree. Also, how are we going to get the word out to these businesses? That's got to be part of our conversation.
Yep.
Because
we're going to be the only ones at the meeting.
And I don't want that to happen. So.
Well, I think the first thing is to figure out when we're going to have it and where we're going to have it.
Absolutely.
And then we can figure out the logistics of making sure that we get the word out. So,
I think the same committee can work on both projects at the same thing. I mean, we're doing the same thing on both.
Okay.
So if you appoint a committee for Holland, they can do them both.
Okay, so what do we do with item number 8? Do we table this or include it as part of number 7?
Included as part of number 7.
Make a motion to have it included as part of number 7.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So somebody needs to make a motion to have it included as part of number 7.
I make a motion we include it in part of number 7.
Second. Excellent, Mike.
Thank you.
That was good.
Very vice president.
Oh, shut up.
Is there a second?
Yeah, second.
Okay. And any other discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Lynn, yes.
Lindemann, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Motion passes. Item number 9, discuss or take action to review and accept one bid for the needed fencing at Big Chief Landing in order to meet with the recently adopted city codes and protect the citizens of Gun Barrel City. In your packet, there are a couple of bids. I am going to throw a monkey wrench into this a little bit for everybody because this is information that was just handed to me today. So I'm going to pass this down. Gary, if you take one, just pass it down. That'd be great.
Got one more. Oh.
We're good.
And for those guys. Also, I'll give you 3 to pass down there. And yours down there. Okay, included in your, just so everybody knows, we put the word out that we needed to get some bids for the fencing that needs to be done. Those of you that have been down the Big Chief Landing, you'll see that there is fencing up there right now, but it is temporary fencing. It's not permanent, and that will be coming down approximately the end of July and needs to be replaced with more permanent type fencing. What we decided to do was not to spend money to drill the posts into each location along the site, but to basically screw in, what do you call those, Megan? What do you call those things?
Anchors.
Yes, thank you. The anchors where the post will sit into, which really cut down on the cost considerably. So in your packet, there were a couple of bids that were included, running from a high of $6,900 for a 4-foot fence along the property to a low of $3,250, which is one of the recent ones you just got. We've also gotten some updates from our friends at Lowe's, who have also provided a bid as well. I think I've been out to the property now 5 times to re-measure it to make sure that we're measuring accurately. And I think we've got everything in really pretty good shape as far as what needs to be done and when it needs to be done. So if you just take a second to gaze through all that, and if you have any questions, we can discuss them.
How come there's 100, almost 100-foot difference in the two bids from Lowe's?
That was a remeasuring. That's why it's brand new.
Like it. The shorter one, correct?
Sorry?
The shorter of the two?
The shorter of the two is the correct one. Yep.
4-foot fence?
Yeah, 4-foot is the minimum that we need. We'll put a cyclone fence up, you know, a chain link fence that will be in there, standard chain link, nothing fancy.
Do we know anything about tidy toilets being able to fence?
We don't.
Do not.
This bid is that there's nothing on it. Lowe's bid's very specific as to what they're going to do.
But it's twice as much.
Twice as much.
I mean,
I know, but
I don't see
tell me what you can see on tidy tots. How big the
Person at a time. Jim?
What's the height of the tidy toilets fence? There's nothing in here.
4-foot.
Redo his bid and put everything in it we need before we can go with this or go with any of it. If it's not going to be 4-foot tall, why are we would we even vote on it? And we just, he hasn't got anything in here saying it is.
I'm just presenting what I got.
I understand. But I think we need to table it till we either get him to redo his bid or throw it out.
Okay, let me back you up 1 second, though. What's our time frame on this, Steve?
The end of the month.
That's when our lease on the fence, the current fencing runs out.
Correct.
Okay, and that is how much per month?
And the posts are going to have to be... It's going to be a special order for us to get the correct mounting brackets for those posts, so we are really in a time crunch.
Why don't we get them to redo this so we could see what their bid is actually, and we could have a special meeting.
Okay. Fine with that.
In the next couple of days. But this is not sufficient to me to...
You can't vote on this. If it's half as much, then they forgot something.
Yeah, there's no consistency to this figure. Yeah, it's like a swimming pool bid.
What you know? if you take the other ones and you really look at them, you know, they're pretty close.
Right.
Okay. This one's like really far off. But
there's no tax on the fencing materials. Did you present it as tax exempt? Because
no, I did not.
I mean, there would be tax on material, not on labor.
Not on labor, but the material.
So to me, this bid is
invalid.
Invalid.
We possibly. Vote on a budgetary amount and resolve these then as long as it's under the budgetary amount so that we don't have to have a special meeting.
That's a great question. The only issue is that they're so completely different.
Right.
I mean, there's $3,000 difference between
right.
them.
I suggest we just throw out the bid from Tidy Toilets. We have bids from Lowe's. We have bids from B&R Fence Company. And with that being said, the Lowe's bid is less than the B&R Fence Company. And I, for one, as good as Megan and Lowe's has been to this city, would like to go with the Lowe's bid.
Thank you.
I'd like to keep the tax dollars in Gun Barrel also.
I agree with Keith totally.
All right.
We've got three bids. We got, they're all itemized as what we're getting. Tidy Tots, like Megan said, is an incomplete deal, and I move that we go with Lowe's $6,020 bid.
Michael?
Second.
Oh, God.
Let's do it.
Second.
Go for
that
it.
That was a motion, right, Jim?
Yep.
And we had a second.
Yes.
Seconded.
Any other discussion?
No.
Voting for my left.
Yes. Osborne.
Slingland, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Very good. Item number 10. So at this time, I'm going to open the public hearing on Project Safari. We have Cecil here. There he is. Cecil, come on up. Say hi to everybody. Wave.
Hello, everybody. Pleased to see you again.
Is there anybody here that wants to make any public statements about Project Safari? Thank you, Cecil. Good to see you again. Item number 11. We're going to close the public hearing on Project Safari. Item number 12. Discuss and or take action to accept the business update from Mike Huckison from Tip Top Auto Repair. I see Mike is here. Mike, come on up to the podium. Don't be shy. And Not that I feel the need to point this out, but Mike looks completely different than I saw him about 10 days ago.
That's because my wife is losing her hair, and I did this in support. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'm a good husband. I'm trying for brownie points. At this stage, it doesn't matter. we need to fix my spelling on my name, too.
I will.
I wouldn't want to issue a check to some fictitious guy.
No problem.
Most people know me. Some people don't. I used to have a shop here in Gun Barrel. I had to vacate the shop because my lease was up. The rent was going up. The building flooded. It was in disrepair, and I just couldn't feasibly keep paying that kind of money. There was nothing else available, so the one available building that I found was in Payne Springs, so I moved over there. Lees has vacated his building about 2.5 months after I moved to Payne Springs, which is the building I really wanted when I came to Gun Barrel, but that's neither here nor there. My plan is to move back into Gun Barrel and take over the building down here at the end of August. I'm asking for a loan from EDC, which I've done this before. My first loan was $15,000. I paid it back over a year and a half early. This time I'm asking for $30,000. Part of the reasoning is it's about $5,400 for my move from Payne Springs to here, which includes moving utilities and advertising and just everything else. Some of the other money will be used for a four-post lift in the building. It's kind of an upgrade for me, to drive up on. The other rest of the money will be divvied out into advertising and overhead and just money to sit on, while making this move and getting reestablished. I guess that's really all I have to say about all that.
Yeah, Mike, we'll invite you into the executive session as soon as we get to that point in the agenda. Any questions from the board for Mike real quick? No? Okay. I wish you had a Fitbit on, Mike. You'd be doing really well. So can I have a motion to accept the business update from Mike?
Yeah, I move that we... take action to accept the business update from Mike.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Slingman, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
If yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Item number 13. Discuss or take action to accept the business update from Glenn at Lakeland Medical Associates. It's not often we get people in here with a lot of ties on, so we're very impressed. Yes. Thank you.
First of all, I want to thank you for allowing us to come tonight and present our update. With me tonight, I have Dr. Douglas Curran, who is one of our physicians, and Mr. Pat Wallace, who is the CEO of ETMC Athens Hospital. The project, basically, Lakeland, we're looking to expand. We've reached a new potential and a growth stopping point with logistics and facilities. Just a brief history about Lakeland for those of you who are not familiar with Lakeland. And this is as it relates to Gun Barrel City. Lakeland Medical Associates first started seeing patients and providing medical care and primary care services for Gun Barrel City residents and the area residents in October of 1998. And then we started sending a physician each day, and they were alternating days part-time here in Gun Barrel. And that continued to grow. And then in October of 2002, we added full-time Dr. Stephen Kurth and Dr. Wally Mahmood full-time here in Gun Barrel seeing patients. And as it continued to grow and the patient's demand kept going up. We added Dr. John Rich in August of 2006 full-time. And then in October of 2012, we added Dr. Bruce Woodall. So to date, we have four full-time physicians here practicing in Gun Barrel City, providing care. Two of the four physicians provide obstetric care for OB services for pregnancy and maternity. So And now we've reached a thing where we've become busier, and patient access is the topic of healthcare these days. And so now we've added a fifth physician, which will be Natalie Hobdy, and she starts in October of this year. Her addition will add, she comes to us, she graduated from Texas Tech University Health Science Center with her doctorate in medicine, and then she's recently finishing up a fellowship in obstetrics. So she will be coming. And in light of this, with the Kauffman OB services ceasing at Kauffman Presbyterian Hospital in May of this year, and their OB doctor retiring, there's a lot of OB services that are needed in this area. So this will draw even more patients and people in the community for doctor's appointments, thus spending money with lunches and tax dollars. Along with her addition, we will be adding five full-time employment positions to accommodate her practice. In conjunction with ETM, East Texas Medical Center Athens, we will be opening in our location also with this expansion, a OB clinic, which will provide services for underprivileged and insured patients who are needing OB care, and establish them with a doctor, a advanced practice provider that checks on them every 4 weeks, and then our doctors do also deliveries at East Texas Medical Center in Athens. Next year, we plan to, the works where we're recruiting two more full-time physicians to rotate between here and Athens, and that will add another 10 full-time positions. Basically, it's about five per provider for their ancillary support. So the project is, we have a building that was built and we released from East Texas Medical Center Athens, and there's shell space, which is just sheetrock, and there's been some potential projects to go in there and it was ceased, so we're returning to original design plans. And so the plan is to build those out to create additional two more work areas for nurses, a doctor's office, a small area for another provider for the OB, and then five more exam rooms. And we're looking to venture out with the city to help with these expansions and promote our services that we offer for the community so our utilization can continue to go up. I believe that's pretty much, and we're asking the $150,000 for that. The construction makes up about $121,740, and then the furniture is about $28,260 for a grand total of $150,000 loan for that.
Can you give us a perspective? I mean, I know the answer to this, but can you tell us, so the rest of the board knows, that how many patients you see within the terms of a month by the current doctors that you have?
Right now, monthly, I've got the yearly written down here, but I do have monthly. We see around 2,000 patients a month with our current doctors. Each of them average anywhere from 400, but let me get my numbers here exactly, so I don't.
That's fine.
You're good.
I've got it right here. So right now, monthly average is 1,982 patients. And last year we had 21,477 visits for the year. And so as a new physician, we can expect her to get up to the average. The first year, usually anywhere from 320 to 350 a month. And then as for the first of year, anywhere from, it'll grow exponentially up to our busiest physician sees anywhere from 500 to 540 patients a month.
And the area reach?
The area we reach pretty much Henderson County. I did a demographic study in Gunbarrel with the zip code. We have currently 55.1% of our patients that live in 75156. And as far as our, we're gaining on Athens, Athens has been in practice, some of the doctors since 1978, so, and they formed in 1995 with the group. It was two individual small practice groups that combined resources into one group to increase efficiency. And Athens currently, for their patients, have about 80%. And I was, Malakoff is 73.6% of our patients live in those. I think the highest one is probably Pointer, who has 48 patients, or 48 according to the census of 2010, and we have 43 that live in there, so it's 89.6. So it ranges, the Kaufman is the lowest at 1.3% of the, but the others range anywhere from 25 to 50%. So
yeah, I wish, so I really wish you knew your numbers better than that. So
pardon me,
wish you knew your numbers better.
Yes, but total Lakeland patients, individual patients, we have 61,466 lives that we touch.
Wow. So. Amazing. So we'll speak with you in the executive session.
I have one
as
question.
Well. You
probably have answered it, okay? But you blended it with Gunbrill City and Athens. Your facility, you're going to build out some currently vacant space at ETMC?
Yes, in our current facility.
Okay, that's what I want. Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Any other questions for Glenn?
No.
Okay. Can I get a motion? Thank you, Glenn.
Thank you.
Can I get a motion to accept the business update from Lakeland Medical Associates?
Glenn, that was a great presentation. I move that we take action to accept the Lakeland Medical Associates. Right?
Update?
Yeah, business update.
Yeah.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
All right. Item number 14. Discuss or take action to accept the initial Gunbarrel City Economic Development Corporation 2016-17 budget. Holland, just a little background. Holland and I spent a lot of time putting together this initial go-through, which we emailed and provided to each of you separately. But the bottom line on this right now is that as we take a look at what we can look at for expenditures for next year and planning a couple of projects, not all of the projects, but planning a couple of the projects, a couple of which we talked about this evening so far, it looks like that in our reserve fund, which is our undesignated reserve, the way that it would sit today is, and we plan, just so you all know, we plan for a very modest increase in sales tax revenue. What do we use, Holland, 5%?
5%.
5% with the lake full. You know, there is a $975,844 undesignated reserve, which leads us to have the ability to work on other projects during the course of the year, because things that we did support last year are currently not included in the top line budget. We have taken the 10% for marketing and totaled that up, so that leaves us with a really healthy reserve on the bottom line. So again, this is the initial budget. I believe the budget's due August the 1st, and this would be what we would be presenting as our initial Economic Development Corporation budget for next year. So it does take into account all of the personnel. There's even a modest increase for personnel. I want the board members to really understand that we've actually allotted a healthy increase to each one of you for all the work that you're doing.
Does that include the limo?
We went from zero to zero, but no, in any event, this took a great amount of time for us to come up with this initial budget, and there's an executive summary that that you all have as well. Can I have a motion to accept the initial Gun Barrel City Economic
Development? I'll make a motion to accept the initial Gun Barrel City Economic Development Corporation 2016-2017 budget.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Left?
Osborne, yes.
Slingerland, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitney, yes.
Motion passes. The Gun Barrel City will now hold a closed executive session meeting pursuant to provisions in Chapter 551 of the Texas Government Code in accordance with the authority contained in Texas Government Code 551.087, deliberations regarding economic development negotiations in Texas Government Code 551. Listed under there, item number 15 would be Project Lakeland, which we'll call you all in. Project number 16 would be Project Tip Top. Mike will call you in as well. We also are going to spend some time, and there's a typo here, deliberate the appointment, employment, evaluation, reassignment duties, and discipline or dismissal of the assistant marketing coordinator, administrative marketing coordinator. That's how it should be listed. As everybody knows, Dawn is back. And we're going to work through some nuances with that. And then item number 18, just an update on Project Lake. So right now it is, before we go into executive session, I'm going to invite Councilman Rob Ray to join us. He's been involved in a couple of these new projects. And so I'm going to invite him to come into the executive session. It is now 5:53, and we're going to convene into executive session. The one, next one. The Gun Barrel, it is now 6:39, and the Gun Barrel City EDC will now reconvene into regular session pursuant to the provisions of Chapter 551 of Texas Government Code. Take any action necessary regarding the items discussed in executive session. Item number 15, Project Lakeland.
I'd like to make a motion that we declare Project Lakeland an official project of the EDC and allocate $150,000 low interest loan against that project and authorize the president to get a performance agreement drawn up.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Slingerland, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Yes.
So be it. Item number 16. Project Tip Top.
I'd like to make a motion that we move Tip Top, Project Tip Top, to be a project designated a project of the EDC and allocate, I believe it's $30,000. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay.
Yes.
$30,000 against that budget and authorize the president of the EDC to get a performance agreement drawn up.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, of course.
Slingerland, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Number 17, deliberate the appointment, employment, evaluation, reassignment, duties, discipline, or dismissal of the administrative marketing assistant.
I make a motion that we change the marketing and administrative assistant from exempt to unexempt, non-exempt.
Second.
A motion and a second. Any other discussion?
I'd like to
go ahead.
Question whether we'd make that a permanent thing or a temporary thing.
Temporary.
Thank you.
Motion to say temporary, correct?
Correct.
Okay, motion. I didn't discuss. Can I get a resecond?
Second.
Any other discussion? Voting from my left.
Osborne, yes.
Slingerland, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Whitten, yes.
Item number 18, Project Lake. Need a motion?
Yeah. I'd like to make a motion that we take I have to back up a sec. Project like that, is it? Is that a project right now? Or that has been, that's what I thought. Okay, I'd like to make a motion that we take Project Lake and list it with a realtor. Negotiations to be handled by Stephen Schiff, the president of the Gunville City EDC.
Second.
Motion and a second. Any discussion? Voting for my left.
Osborne, yes.
Slinglin, yes.
Lindeman, yes.
Schiff, yes.
Damiano, yes.
Butler, yes.
Motion for adjournment.
Motion to adjourn.
Amen.
Thank you.